Well, President Rodrigo Duterte signs the 5 trillion peso 2022 national budget into law, the biggest in the country's history. He also signed a law creating the Department of Migrant Workers. Pia Gutierrez joins us on the line for details. Pia, good afternoon, and what more can you tell us?
Yes, that's right, Rain. President Rodrigo Duterte on Thursday signed into law the national budget for 2022 in a ceremony in Malacanang attended by lawmakers and government officials. The budget, amounting to 5.024 trillion, is the biggest in history and includes funds for addressing the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic and the aftermath of Super Typhoon Odette, which brought much devastation in various parts of the country. Among the notable allocations of the budget are 50 billion pesos for the special risk allowance for medical frontliners and almost 48 billion pesos for the procurement of COVID-19 booster shots. The Department of Budget and Management also earlier announced that at least 4 billion pesos pledged by the President to assist victims of Typhoon Odette would be sourced from the 2022 spending plan. President Duterte in his speech said that the signing of the 2022 budget reaffirms the government's strong commitment to provide a more comfortable and productive life for each Filipino. He adds that the budget is guided by a strategy supported by three main pillars of building resiliency amidst the pandemic, sustaining the momentum towards recovery, and continuing the legacy of infrastructure development. The president, meanwhile, also expressed concern over the growing threat of the Omicron variant, noting the increase of cases in other countries. He worries that the new variant may trigger yet another surge in the country and dampen government efforts to rebuild the Philippine economy, which have already been much affected by the pandemic. Should that happen, Duterte urged lawmakers to pass new laws needed to cope with the problem to ensure that the country continues to recover from the pandemic. Meanwhile, in the same program, the president also signed a law creating the Department of Migrant Workers, as well as another law extending the availability of the 2021 national budget to December 31, 2022. Malacanang says the new measure will allow government agencies to fully utilize the unused budget for 2021 for the implementation of priority programs and projects. Rain?
Thank you so much for that report. Pia Gutierrez.